What's up, everybody? Welcome to Gamingtech. I hope everybody is doing good today. Today it's raining today. It's a strange weather. Anyway, these are the two fans that I'm using in my water cooling system. We're gonna use this Arctic Clean to clean our processor. This is one of the CPU coolers that I have been using. Unfortunately, I gave it away. That's why I can't show it here. I just have the box only. This is trash. Throw it, get rid of it, never buy that one. This is the backplate of the motherboard. There's Intel version, there's AMD version. This is basically serving the role of keeping the cooler attached to the motherboard with the support. We don't need to take off this part. Taking this cooler is relatively easy. Only four screws are holding it, and we have the CPU fan header. That's about it. As you see, it is extremely easy procedure to do, doesn't take long, super simple. I'm just clumsy, so for me it takes extra while. There you go, we wiggle a little bit, easily. On the previous video we saw the thermal paste, how it's looking. We're gonna be using this. Normally this is something luxurious. You can just use electronic cleaner, or you can just wipe it with a piece of toilet paper. Whatever you prefer. By the way, you will notice once you wiped it off with the toilet paper, it's not fully clean. This doesn't harm the system anyway. I have these laying around. Why not use it? Why not show it to people? Some people had the curiosity over it, so this is the opportunity to take a look at it. The solutions are with step 1 and step 2. As you see, it was looking clean. But that's the residue of the thermal paste that came off. Now we're gonna use the second one. I usually tend to use 2 drops. Super easy to do. But with electronic cleaner, it's even easier. Done. These are the stands off for the AIO that I was gonna attach to the system before. 4 of them on each corner. Here we weigh the CPU cooler of the Cooler Master. It's a horrible cooler. It's meant to replace the stock cooler. Why would you want to get this? Just to have 12 volt RGB? Not worth it. We're using the Arctic Clean MX4 thermal paste. I heard in Turkey that a fake version of this exists, so watch out, guys. On the label of the package, it says 2019 version, so better watch out. It has a sandy texture, the fake one. I tend to apply the thermal paste like this. At the end of the video, I will show it again, much more slower. Here we install our AIO, very simple procedure, nothing difficult here. We put the stands off, you can put washer in between, it's not necessary here. Those are the one that holds the AIO locked in place, directly going on top of the stands off. Very simple procedure, nothing difficult about it. Here we could see the label print of the thermal paste on the copper. This AIO been through a lot. It's an old version, H100V2, something like that. Here I do the same procedure here. Since people asked about this, step 1 and step 2, it's nothing necessary. It's not gonna affect your temperatures, nothing. But as you see, it removes the residue very easily, and it has very pleasant smell. Like a lemon smell. And the step 2, super easy, super easy. Gonna use that toilet paper again. And then I just put it back in the box because it served its purpose for the video. And we're not wasting any toilet paper here. You know, there was shortage of toilet paper in the world thanks to, you know. Easily cleanable. I place the back of the plastic of it and it goes back to its original box. I was able to overclock with this small AIO on my 8700K up to 5 GHz. In winter I was able to push even 5.1, but it wasn't stable. Anyway, let's move on. That was the original box. I have no idea what kind of boxes Corsair is doing today. With the screws, that's the AMD bracket, that's the Intel bracket. No idea why one of them is plastic, the other one is metal. Here I clean the processor again. Very easy procedure. I repeat the same thing here again. Just one or two drops, depending on how much you want to use. That's the warranty sticker. I mean, I would shoot that cooler normally. It's horrible. Like, why would you want to replace your stock cooler just to have a couple of lights going? MX4 thermal paste. MX4 thermal paste. Super easy to work with. I tend to put it in the middle, then I spread it over the processor. That's how I do it. Everybody has their own technique. Some people say this method is not good. It's always worked out very good for me. You can place in the middle also and just let it spread also. It's super easy to work with. I personally love this method, and when I check my temperature, I see all of the cores similar within the same temperature range. That way I know I've done a good job. This is nothing much you need to do. Some people tend to do X method. If you got good temperatures, that's about it. I believe there is a new version of Cryonaut, a pink version. That's gonna have higher rating, but I need to check that out. I haven't checked and I haven't used that one. I had this laying around and this serves the purpose very nicely. It's raining a lot here today. Wow. As you see, it's very simple procedure. I cover the edges everywhere smoothly. Just like you're spreading that cake's whipped cream. Super easy. I'm removing the standoffs here that were used for the AIO because we don't need them. Normally you would attach the backplate here, but since I know the Intel system is gonna fit with the AIO there, there was no point of removing it. Here I install it back. Afterwards I'm gonna put in the fan header. Never forget that. And then don't ask yourself why this fan is not spinning. Super easy procedure. I hope this is gonna be helpful for people who have asked this. That's the fan header that goes into the CPU fan header. It's labeled on the motherboard as well. The other camera battery died, so I had to use the phone here. So the footage is slightly worse quality, but the idea is just to show you here. Done. Thank you for watching, guys. See you on the next video. I will be showing the fans I've been using, the white versions of the Arctic ones. If you have any questions, you can drop a comment on the comment section. Thank you for watching. See you on next video. Let's go.